All right, in this video, we're going to write an equation for a line that passes through a point and that we also have a given slope for. So we are given a point, 4, negative 3, and a slope of 3 eighths. So we are going to use the point slope formula because we have places that we can plug those values in. Let's look at those given values and identify what parts of the formula that we have. In this case, this point is considered to be x1, y1. So the 4 would be x1 and the negative 3 would be y1. We also have a slope or an m that is 3 eighths. And those are the three values that we can plug into the formula. Notice that the negative 3 will get plugged in first and then the 3 eighths and then the 4. When you plug in a negative value, make sure that you honor the subtraction in the formula and the negative that you plug in. So the first part of this is going to be y minus negative 3 equals, and then your 3 eighths for your slope, and then the quantity x minus 4. Since you plug in a positive 4, you don't have to worry about that at the end there. Now, you will be solving this equation for y, and that will give you the equation of the line. But first we need to clean up the left-hand side with that double negative. So y minus negative 3, if you keep change, or if you just use the rules for subtracting integers, that will change to y plus 3 equals, and then we're going to go ahead and distribute the 3 eighths. You're going to multiply 3 eighths times x to get 3 eighths x, and then you'll multiply 3 eighths times negative 4. And I've got a little whiteboard for you to show you what, if you want to do it by hand. But when you do that multiplication, you should get negative 3 halves. And we're going to write that as minus 3 halves. The next thing we're going to do is take a look at the left-hand side of the equation, and we will need to subtract that 3. And this is our final step, really. So we will subtract the 3 from both sides, and that will eliminate the 3s from the left-hand side, and you just have to focus on negative 3 halves minus 3. Again, if you want to do this by hand, I've got the work put out for you. You do have to get common denominators, and if you do it in your calculator, either way, you should get negative 9 halves as your answer. So that will give us the final line of y equals 3 eighths x minus 9 halves. And that will be the equation that we would write for the line that passes through 4, negative 3, and has a slope of 3 eighths. Okay, I'm going to give you an opportunity to practice the skill on your own, so go ahead and pause the video, and I'll have the answer for you in a minute. And here is the full answer for you, so you can see where everything was plugged in and how it was handled. Good luck to you as you continue to use this skill moving forward.